Good morning. Welcome to the special edition of TNN. I'm Junie.
And I'm Brandon. Today is February 5th. Thank you for joining us.
Today's 21st century programs are MMA, Learn to Sew, and Strategic Games.
This week's Millennial's Tip is about swapping snack foods. Instead of candy bars, try protein bars. Instead of potato chips, try some trail mix with nuts and seeds. Instead of soda, try sparkling water.
Pentec's annual open house event will take place tomorrow night.
This month's character trait is fairness. Fairness is the treatment or behavior without favoritism or discrimination.
The mock trial team was 4-0 in the jury decision throughout the Camden County Bar Association competition last weekend. The team was 2-2 on the judge decision during the competition. Congratulations.
The Winter Pep Rally was held on January 25th. There were activities such as bottle flip challenges, obstacle course races, and a basketball shootout competition between athletes. In this assembly, we honored out winter athletes on and off campus. We also took our time to dedicate this rally to Derek Hawkins. Our thoughts go out to his friends and family.
Now, let's go to Marvin with the weather.
Thanks, Junie. Saturday was Groundhog Day, and if you didn't already hear, Phil predicted an early spring. This week's weather definitely looks like he was right. On that note, today will be 58 degrees with partly cloudy skies. Wednesday will be colder at 46 degrees, but still sunny. Thursday will be cloudy with temperatures in the high 50s. And Friday will be rainy with temperatures of 63 degrees. That's all I have for you today. Back to you, Brandon.
As Marvin said, Groundhog Day was Saturday. A crowd of 30,000 people gathered in Pennsylvania to see the famous groundhog Phil. The groundhog did not see a shadow, which means spring will come early this year. This is only the 19th time in 133 years that the groundhog did not see a shadow.
The boys' varsity basketball team faced Wilson High School in front of a packed gym here at Pentec on the 25th. The Tornadoes pulled out an emotional victory, 66-50. The win raised Pentec's record to 12-4. Jay White led seniors with 26 points. Jeff Broadwater added 17 points and 12 rebounds. The team was featured on NJ.com for the victory. The Tornadoes traveled to Camden Charter on Tuesday and played at home on Wednesday against Princeton Day School.
On Tuesday, the girls' basketball team played Lindenwald. On Wednesday, they played Camden Academy. And they played Audubon on Friday.
Congratulations to Dante Guest, a junior in law and public safety who won the 4x200 team race at the state relays for Camden High. On Tuesday, the bowling team played in the NJTAC tournament on Wednesday. They played Cherry Hill West, and Thursday they played Mastery Charter.
We interviewed some of the Pentec students and staff to see who they were rooting for. Let's see how many of them predicted the winner correctly.
I got New England Patriots.
The Rams.
Definitely the Patriots. I mean, you can't kill greatness.
For sure, Tom Brady going to win another Super Bowl.
Nobody now because Dallas are out, which I'm glad about, but since the Eagles, my team are out, there's no point about the Super Bowl for me this year.
Well, if the Eagles aren't in it, who cares?
I like the Los Angeles Rams 34-20.
I mean, if the Eagles aren't in it, really, who cares? But I don't think anybody wants to see the Pats win.
I got the Rams for the Super Bowl because I don't want the Patriots to win, but I already know the Patriots are going to end the winning for the Super Bowl. So.
Nah, I go for the Rams, but I know they're taking it all. I'm sick of the Patriots.
Well, I don't want no Patriots to win, so I got to go with the Rams.
That's all we have for you today.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you on Friday.